Okay, graphing quadratic functions when they're in the vertex form. Quadratics are parabolas. So standard form is the form that we were doing last time where you could factor it. Vertex form is the ax minus h squared plus k. Okay, and that tells you what the vertex is because the vertex is h comma k. So here, I would write this down. A is your vertical stretch, and so it's skinnier if A is greater than 1, and it's wider if A is between 0 and 1. H is your horizontal shift, and K is your vertical shift. Okay, this table right here is telling us, so when we were to graph parabolas, so if we have some graph, and we have the x squared function. So we have y equals x squared. Well, we could graph this by just plugging numbers in. So if we did x and y, I'm going to start with 0. Well, if I plug 0 in, so if x equals 0, y is going to be 0 squared, which is 0. So that means I have a point here. I should have done this in different colors. So this is 0 and this is 0. So I have a point here at 0, 0. Okay, if I plug 1 in, 1 squared is 1. And I'm just plugging it in up here, so I'm doing 1 squared. But if I plug negative 1 in, negative 1 squared is also 1. So that means I go left 1, up 1 here, same thing here. Why is it doing that? Okay, if I plug 2 in, 2 squared is 4. If I plug negative 2 in, that's also 4. So I go negative 2 up 1, 2, 3, 4. And then right 2 up 4. I could do the same with 3. 3 squared is 9. Negative 3 squared is positive 9 also. So I go back 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So it's clear up there. And same thing here. So there is our parent function of a quadratic. Okay, these right here are going to be very important when we're dealing with our a values. Okay, let's get into some of these though. So let's look at this one. So we have y equals 2, x minus 4 squared minus 3. So first we want to figure out what our vertex is. So our a is 2. Our h is, since this is a negative right here, it's always opposite of whatever this is. So since that's a negative 4, that means h equals positive 4. You can also think about this as if you were like solving it. So if we have x minus 4 equals 0, you could just add the 4 over and you get x equals 4. Okay, same thing. And then k equals negative 3, so k is our last number. Our vertex here is h comma k. So our vertex is, oh, and wait, our axis of symmetry is x equals h. So our vertex is 4 comma negative 3. So I'm going to go over 4, down 3, and there is our vertex. Okay, our axis of symmetry is x equals h, so it's going to be x equals 4. And that's just a dotted line. That means axis of symmetry means that we could fold the paper along that dotted line. Like if I could take my screen out and fold it. But you could fold it over that dotted line and it will be symmetric on both sides. So they'll fold on top of each other. Okay. Now we have to deal with our a value. So our a value is vertically stretching this by 2. Which really means that we're going to take all of these values here and multiply them by 2. Okay, usually you go over 1, up 1, and over 1, up 1. This time, instead of going over 1, up 1, we're going to go over 1, up 2. So that's going to be there. I did that really fast. But over 1, up 2, to the right, up 2, to the left, up 2. Now, usually when you go over 2, you go up 4, but now I'm going to multiply that by 2. So when I go over 2, I'm actually going to go up 8. And then I go to the left 2, and I also go up 8. Okay, and then there is my parabola. Let's do this one. So negative 1 half x plus 2 squared minus 1. So a equals negative 1 half, h equals negative 2, and k equals negative 1. So that means I go negative 2, down 1, there's my vertex. Axis of symmetry is x equals negative 2, so that's right there. And then this is reflected across the x-axis, and it's vertically compressed by 1 half. But we can just do it all in one step. So we're going to take these numbers right here and multiply them by negative 1 half. So normally I go over 1, up 1, but this time I'm going to go over 1, down a half. Okay. And then to the left 1, down a half. I usually go over 2 and up 4, but this time I'm going to multiply 4 by negative 1 half, and it's going to be negative 2. And same thing right there. You could do the same thing with 9. Half of 9 is 4.5, so that's going to be right there and right there. Okay. Hopefully you're remembering this. Okay, so completing the square, you've also done this before. Hopefully. Completing the square is more fun than it sounds. Yep. So if we have x squared minus 2x plus 4, this is not factorable. We cannot factor it. So we have to do it by completing the square. To complete the square, I have no idea what I'm doing. To complete the square, I'm going to separate the first two terms by themselves. So the x squared plus minus 2x by itself, and then we're just going to leave the 4 alone on the right side. We're going to take whatever's with our x, and we're going to divide it by 2. So I'm going to do negative 2 divided by 2, and I get negative 1. Then I'm going to square the negative 1, and I get positive 1. So I am going to add the 1 to the inside of the parentheses, and I'm also going to subtract the 1 to negate what I just did. I cannot change this equation, and so that's why we have to, if we add 1 here, I also have to subtract 1, because if I add 1 and I subtract 1, it's really the same as just adding 0. So there's no change to the equation. Okay. Very important. Do not forget to do that. And then if you were to factor this now, so I want to see what multiplies to be 1, adds to be negative 2. Well, that's negative 1 and negative 1. So that's going to be x minus 1, which can be written as x minus 1 squared, which is why it's called completing the square. Whatever this number is always going to be that number right there. Okay. And then 4 minus 1 is 3. Now this looks like something that we can graph. That was easier than I thought. So we're going to pull up our graph, h comma k. So our h is 1, our k is 3, and our a is 1 also. So I have a vertex at 1, 3, which is right there. I have an axis of symmetry at x equals 1. And then since a equals 1, if we remember our table, we had x, y, and it was like negative 3, 9, negative 2, 4, negative 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 4, 3, 9. So I'm going to go left 1, up 1, right 1, up 1. And then I'm going to go left 2, up 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then right 2, up 4. There is our parabola. Okay, this is important. Write this down. Important. Okay, cool. So there's that, and there you go. Let's do another one. So we have 2x squared minus 16x plus 33. So first, I want to group those first two together. I can't factor this, so let's group those first two together. And then I want my leading coefficient to be 1. So I'm going to divide by 2 here. So I'm going to divide by 2, and I get x squared minus 8x plus 33. Now I can divide that 8 by 2. So negative 8 divided by 2 is negative 4. square it, and I get 16. So that means I'm going to add 16 on the inside, but I added 32 on the outside. Why did I add 32 on the outside? Well, if we think about this, 2 times 16 is 32. So really, on the inside, I added 32, which is why I also had to subtract 32. Okay, so since we pulled out a GCF up here, when I add in this 16 again, I have to remember that GCF. So this really is the same as adding 32 right there. So I have to subtract 32 out here to end up getting the 0. Okay. But now this will become easier for us. So we're going to have y equals 2 and then x minus 4 squared plus 1. Graph this. So a equals 2, h equals 4, k equals 1. Vertex is 4, comma 1, so I can go over 4, up 1. Axis of symmetry is x equals 4, so that's right there. And then my a equals 2, so again, we want to look at our table. So hopefully you have this somewhere. This is like the 100th time I've said it. Negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 9, 4, 1, 0, 1, 4, 9. So now, instead of going over 1, up 1, I'm going to multiply all of these here by 2. So I'm going to go over 1, up 2, over 1, up 2. And then I'm going to go over 2, up 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that's going to be like somewhere up here. There would be our parabola. Okay. And there's all that. Perfect. Okay, let's do another. So negative x squared minus 4x minus 7. Group those first two. I'm going to pull out the negative. So I'm going to have negative x squared plus 4x and then minus 7. 4 divided by 2 is 2. 2 squared is 4. So I'm going to add 4 to the inside. And it looks like I added 4 to the outside too. Why did I do that? So it's a similar reason to what we did before. Whoa, sorry, my voice is like going. Okay, hopefully it's back. Okay, so it's a similar reason to what we did before. I'm going to multiply that negative in. So really, on the inside, that's like subtracting 4. So I have to add 4 on the outside. So this right here is really negative 4. So I have to add the 4 on the outside to end up not changing this equation. Okay. So then that's going to factor down to x plus 2 squared, and then negative 7 plus 4 is negative 3. So our a value here is negative 1 now, because there's a negative on the outside. You can always think of this as a 1 there. H is negative 2, and k is negative 3. Vertex is negative 2, negative 3, so I'm going to go over 2, down 3. And axis of symmetry is x equals negative 2. And normally, I would go over 1, up 1, but since it's a negative now, I'm going to go over 1, down 1, over 1, down 1, over 2, down 4, over 2, down 4. Okay. Done, finito, finished. Okay, bye.